We want to welcome you here to Crossfire's update. And man, we've got a lot of things in the holidays that we've just finished up. And I want to talk about that for just a little bit. I know there's a lot of people today that I'm getting calls and people saying, man, I miss the candlelight service. Are you doing one on Christmas Eve? And the answer to that is we do not do a candlelight service on Christmas Eve. We do it the Sunday previous to Christmas. And all I can say is we're going to have an incredible candlelight service in December 2016. We do it once a year. It's the same basic service, but boy, each and every year, such a unifying family event. And has any of you had good positive feedback, testimonies?
I mean, yeah, I've had heard a couple of people. They love how family oriented it is, and you know, they get to spend time, and it's honestly a real intimate time that you get with your family. I mean, a lot of times, you know, when we're outside of this place, and you know, we're just living life, we can get so busy and caught up, and this time is like a dedicated time for that, and people love that.
You know, I've watched some that I've been counseling and working with that are having trouble within their own marriage, and I watched them, you know, making covenants and commitment to each other and talking about how much they appreciated, tears rolling down their face, you know, children crying. I mean, it was just what an incredible family time. I'm going to start choking up right now. But what a great time. So I want to encourage you to come and always be a part of that. But, you know, it's the important part is to be a part of what is happening within the body of Christ, within the local church. You know, God put that together for a purpose. He didn't say, oh, watch. He wouldn't say, oh, watch the body of Christ. He didn't say, you know, I hope they're all perfect, because they're not. We're all, as it says in that service, we're all jars of clay that are broken, that are, you know, we're imperfect, but we have the Holy Spirit within us. And with that, we have the opportunity to really be able to love one another, even though we're imperfect. The Christ within us has such a genuine perfectness, perfection, that, man, I'll tell you what, it's incredible when we just break down our flesh and begin to care about people from the God inside of us. And I think that service really just conveys that very well. I also want to take a minute and say thank you to all those that put the hayride together, the children's program this month, you know, our staff and Home Group United Christmas party together. We had a great time. Yeah. We've also had a great time just reaching out individually with feeding those that are hungry, those that are hurting, helping with clothing, all the different things that we do to reach out during this time. The thing that I think is unique about Crossfire is instead of just reaching out at the holiday season, we try to make sure that what we do is something we do month after month, year after year. But there's always something special about reaching out during the Christmas season. Yeah. But we want to make sure we continue. People have needs all year long. And it seems like there's a lot of hype around Thanksgiving and Christmas. But the truth is, people have needs as a church. Those may be high times. Those might be, you know, really exciting times. A lot of people getting together. But it's really, really important that we reach out all year long. Yeah. And I think this ministry is very effective in doing that. I also want to just take a minute before we get into all the little different things going on and just say that we're in the process of either refinancing or selling our youth camp. And we need your prayers on that. It's not something we necessarily want to do, but we need people to financially just continue with us so that we don't have to take drastic measures like this. And so we just ask you to be in prayer that the church elders and board make the right decision when it comes to having to sell different property. We're actually hoping to maybe sell the property and be able to rent it back on a 20-year lease so we can continue to use the property for the next 20 years. We're okay with that too. Yeah, so we'll see what God's got in store for some crazy thing. But no matter what, we're going to continue as a church. We're going to continue to reach out. We're going to continue to help people. Just met last week with a new program where we can begin to house people, basically 12 people at a time who are homeless and living in their cars and struggling, some with children, some without, and be able to provide some limited housing for that. There's just a lot of projects, a lot of things going on, but it all takes funding. Yeah. You know, it all takes funding. And so I want to encourage you to pray with us for that. Before I turn over all these other crazy things going on, we have a New Year's celebration, a New Year's Eve celebration, excuse me, a New Year's Eve celebration. It's broke up at different houses. You can find it online. You can go to different houses, pick one that's close to you, one that, you know, you can just find a great time to celebrate and enjoy the new year with different family and different people within the congregation, where they're going to open up their houses and have a time of celebration and a lot of fun. So I'm excited about that. It's Thursday night after Christmas, because mm-hmm. we're filming this before Christmas. It'll show before, during, and after Christmas. and so it will be a great time. I encourage you to be a part of that New Year's service. So I've got a few more minutes. Could you start at the end down there? You got a couple things rooted and kids' church you're going to talk about. Right. Do that quick.
All right. So we have our women's conference rooted coming up, and it is January 8th and 9th, so Friday night and all day Saturday. And it's going to be an amazing time. I've been to several of them, and I don't like missing them, so I'm so excited for them. We've been anticipating it since the last one, and we can't wait. It's going to be at our South Eugene campus. You can pick up a flyer in our foyer or check it out online for more information. But it's coming up quick, so it's next month. So invite your friends, tell people about it, and pick up a flyer in the foyer and just see how you can get involved and stuff like that. And so also we have our Kids Town Ministries, which if you want to be a part of it, you can fill out a flyer and just put it in our information booth, and you can see how you can get involved in kids ministry, either Kids Town itself or Kids Town Junior or toddler age. So let us know.
What do you got, Kevin?
So Crossfire Masters Commission, right now the students are on their Christmas break, so if you guys could be praying for them, praying that they make wise decisions, and but just be praying.
Is that coming from a master's director who used to be a student?
Yes, exactly.
Didn't always make wise decisions?
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
No, I know. You know, with the students, they've been in for a couple months now, and they've just been at the church pretty much 24/7, and now they're going to be at home unsupervised for a week and a half, and so if you guys could just be praying for them. For you guys who do not know, Crossfire Masters Commission is a discipleship program for people who want to get to know God more and establish a foundation. It is for the ages of 18 to 25, but you can pick up a flyer in the foyer, or you can go onto our website, which is on the Crossfire website. And then also, we have our December calendar. So this has all, I know December's almost over.
But you got January right around the corner.
We do, and we have our January calendars prepared, but you can pick up the calendars out in the foyer, and basically just lines up all the events that we have going on at both campuses, so.
All right,
I wanted to talk about our prayer ministry. Healthy Church is a church that is involved in prayer, and there's many ways for you to be involved in the prayer at our church. We have an online prayer blog that you can get involved with by going up and signing up and giving us your email address. Every time we post a prayer request, it'll be sent out to you, and you can pray on Tuesday mornings.
Let me say that. I just posted, someone sent me a prayer request, and I prayed for them, and then I sent it right to the prayer request line, just so that, and it'll get out today. Yes. People will be able to pray, so they can not only post a prayer request, they can also sign up to begin to receive those,
right,
so they can be prayer warriors.
Exactly. And also, if you want to come out to the church every Tuesday morning at between 9 and 10 in the morning, we have a staff prayer that's open to the public. You can come in, we share prayer requests, and then we pray for the online prayer requests, and as well as we text out and see if anybody needs prayer, prayer. So that's a good way to be personally involved if you want to come into the church and pray. Also, we are involved with a program with a bunch of other churches in the local area, and it's called the 24-Hour Prayer, One Church, One Day. So every third Tuesday, we have a 24-hour slot of prayer time that we're trying to fill with people who will take a half an hour to out of their day to pray for the needs of the community or any kind of things that need to be prayed for. The next one for our church is going to be January 19th. So you can be involved with that. You can take a time slot for prayer on that Tuesday and pray for our community and our church.
It's awesome. All right, we want to thank all of you for joining us, and really appreciate everyone who's faithful here at our church, and they continue to labor, continue to pray, and continue to be faithful financially so we can continue doing what God has called us to do. Thank you.